Good morning, everybody, and welcome to Wake Up Missoula. I'm your host, Scott Ramph. Today is August 23rd, 2017. It is my 29th birthday today, but I'm going to spend my birthday talking about the city that I love, that is Missoula. So let's talk about some of the things I'm going to be showing you guys today. I have a lot of video clips. I got some videos that I've basically collected from the internet that kind of highlight the solar eclipse that happened on Monday. I got some weather. I got your report for some unhealthy smoke and particulate matter that is in the Missoula Valley. But we're going to kick things off with a little bit of weather. It's going to be hot today with a high of 90 degrees outside. You have a haze. I really like the stock photo of basically having the cityscape. But of course, that's usually what they use in like California and whatnot for their morning haze. You have a low of 56 tonight. You have a slight chance of thunderstorms. Hopefully that thunderstorms will continue on through Thursday with that chance of showers that will basically clear out some of the smoke that's in the area. But of course, it'll clear out for maybe a day or so. Hopefully we'll get a nice clear day for your Thursday and Friday for the River City Roots Festival that'll be coming this week. MCAT will be doing the River City Roots Festival. I'll talk a little bit more about that later in the show. But let's talk about everything that's happening besides the fire, which is basically currently at more than 30,000 acres in the Lolo Peak Fire, which is where all the smoke is coming from, just so you guys know. If you don't already know that, that's basically where the smoke is coming from. But let's talk about something a little better news in Missoula. In September, the Montana Board of Regents will take up naming the Academic Hall of Liberal Arts Building the Dennis and Gretchen Eck Hall, and UM officials are crossing their fingers that the new grand entrance that opens up the building to the Oval will be ready in time to celebrate during homecoming. So if you don't know what building the Liberal Arts Building is, it is the giant E building. So it's a building that was modeled to look like an E. If you're able to go up to Mount Sentinel and look down at the Oval, it's the building that's shaped like an E. So Dennis Eck and his wife Gretchen pledged $8 million to the University of Montana over the last 3 years, and among their donations, it totals around $6 million currently have already been donated to the University of Montana. Especially, they want to move it to the Liberal Arts Department because Dennis was a student of the UM 50 years ago and went through the Liberal Arts Department. The Liberal Arts Department was built in 1953, and it's basically, they want to renovate the academic corridor, the long edge of the letter. Comer said he hopes that in the future the shorter edge will, where faculty work can be redone one at a time as well. X said that the project demonstrates UM can upgrade its older buildings without tearing them down, and he hopes that other donors and politicians will be moved to support the university in the future. But in national news, Trump is defending comments more about Charlottesville, more Trump stuff, and apparently a bunch of Haitians are leaving for asylum in Canada from the U.S. because of Trump. Just a lot of the same old stuff that's been happening around the United States and this and that, but I want to really talk about something that really has affected everybody, especially in the North American region, and that is the solar eclipse. Last time it happened in North America region was in 1979, but even so, the last full long eclipse that we have in this magnitude was in the 1910s. The next one of this scale will be in 2135, give or take a year. The next solar eclipse that's actually supposed to happen in the U.S. North America is going to be April 8th, 2024. So here is a clip from basically a whole bunch of videos from NASA, Idaho, Falls, all sorts of things kind of like encompassing what it was like to live in the eclipse. If you were in Missoula during the eclipse, it's basically, just the tiniest sliver that was exposed from the solar eclipse didn't get enough of that what you'd expect from total darkness. But what you guys did expect, there was a drop in temperature, and basically, if you were to really pay attention, that the solar eclipse, basically, imagine what the world would look like, especially in the Montana region, if you wore sunglasses. It's kind of like a sunglass filter in the Missoula area. And okay, without further ado, here's a clip of a bunch of videos from NASA and beyond about the solar eclipse. Thank you. All right, guys, now let's give you your Missoula air quality update. Here is the map of the in Montana of the air quality. Red is unhealthy. The darker maroon color is considered very unhealthy. But we don't have any purple, because we did have purple not too long ago, and that is usually hazardous for anybody who goes outdoors. But unhealthy is what it is currently at, and we may see very unhealthy conditions happening as well. If you take a look at this map here, the PM count usually peaks around 11, 12, and then it kind of starts going down after 1 p.m. So you can expect some of these, the air quality get a little bit worse, maybe this morning as well, but things will get a little bit more improved. And they give you kind of like an hour by hour scale. Earlier this morning started at 49.7, which has more than doubled at 122.5 particulate matter. And for those of you who don't know what particulate matter is, imagine a strand of your hair, but that's basically 3% of the size of a single strand of hair, and then add it up with all those numbers as well. And you can see how thick some of the particulate matter that is in the air that's coming from all the smoke. So that's kind of what's happening with your air quality. But hopefully that rain will happen on Thursday morning, hopefully clearing it out for maybe a day or two, so the River City Roots Festival will be good. MCAT is doing the River City Roots Festival. We're doing the Kids Festival at Karis Park. We'll be there basically running our virtual reality setup, so we have VR, so kids get a chance to, I guess in a way, I know it's counterintuitive because it's kind of like, oh, we're going to be outside and about in the city and all that stuff, but we're going to put basically two televisions to your children's eyes while they play virtual reality games. And so yeah, that's kind of like that's kind of what's going to happen for our aspect of the River City Roots Festival. I'll talk a little bit more about the River City Roots Festival on Friday when it happens, and I'll talk about all the events that are going to be happening and all the acts and all the musicians that will be happening at the River City Roots Festival. But I just kind of wanted to tease that MCAT will be there for the River City Roots Festival and the Boys and Girls Club. So we're going to be there from 11 to about 9-ish o'clock. I say 9-ish because it does say we're 6 to 9:30 is when they're having a Boys and Girls Club kind of like send-off, because it's the last day of the Boys and Girls Club, and they're doing this nice little celebration during the Roots Festival. Maybe not, I mean, it's correlating with the Roots Festival. I don't know if it's actually with the Roots Festival, but that's kind of what's happening, and MCAT's going to be there from 11 to 9 on Friday, and then again Saturday from 11 to like 5. And then that's pretty much it for our involvement with the River City Roots Festival. Last couple of years, we've done it. We did a virtual reality ride with a space taxi. It was very popular, and there's always a kid that wants to do space taxi. But this year, we're going to do more of our virtual reality stuff, since we've gotten a little bit better in terms of transporting our equipment. And it's a lot better than renting a U-Haul and just using that instead. But we have a bunch of new programs that are going to be airing on MCAT. So here is a basically a nice little highlight videos of everything that's new on MCAT for the next couple days. And then when I come back, I'm going to talk all about your city council. So they're talking about all sorts of wonderful things during the city council, including proclamation and more. So I'll get to that as soon as we get done watching this video. So stay with me. I got some city council right after this.
And in places like Williamstown, is apart from development pressures, we also have pressures of estate buyers, second home buyers, people who will buy a farm for its aesthetic values and take it out of production, so the community loses all those social benefits, the food, all the stuff I talked about earlier, because the land's gone to the highest bidder. So this preempts that.
It was a good sounding board. It was a human being in the community that they could relate to, that could kind of just mentor by example. They could demonstrate, this is how you make decisions, functional decisions. when I screen people in the treatment court, I ask tons of really invasive questions. And one of them is, how many sober friends do you have? Usually the answer is zero. And so the beauty of a peer recovery coach is, even if they don't know how to go out and make a friend, because sometimes those friends that they've had, they've had for years and years and years. They've been using with together for years. They don't even know how to go out and make a sober friend.
There's always a lot to unpack. I'm from Kalispell. I live in Missoula. I am this little white Montanan girl through and through. I've done some traveling, but I've never lived in a city, you know, and so there's a lot of recognized blind spots that I might have, and I think that it's important now, as you said, for the churches to also look at what blind spots they might have and accept them, like say, you know what, these are here, and it's okay, like let's recognize them for what they are, they're here, now let's do something about them, because it's easy to get caught up in the guilt of having that presence anyways, of whenever I find racism in myself, because it happens, and it's always very embarrassing to me when it does. But it doesn't mean that it wasn't there, but if I surround myself in the feelings of guilt once I find it, nothing gets done really. I wallow in it and it doesn't change my reactions for later. Nothing inside of me changes. I just end up in a negative space for a while.
And I introduced Mike and Deb at a Tuba Christmas event. Oh gosh. God, and they made it 21 years. Here's their song, Happy Anniversary Kids. Here's It Had to Be You. Arranged by Mike Rosbarski. There you go.
And the Missoula City Band kicks off this week as well for the very first performances. So if you guys missed the summer series, or you guys want to look back and see some of the summer concert series from the Missoula City Band, it starts airing this week and will be going on congruently pretty much for the next couple weeks. And there are a couple more concerts this year than they have in the last couple of years. Gary Gillette is this is his first summer. He just celebrated his first year of retirement from Sentinel High School after teaching for over 40 years at Sentinel High School. So you get to check out that and more of see what he's done for the Missoula City Band. So, sorry, I'm just like thinking way too much before I talk. So here is some city council reports. So we'll start off with some public comments. Jesse Ramos, who's been going to a bunch of public city meetings, he's running for Ward 4 City Council, and he's talking about what the city should be doing in terms of using its revenue funds for veterans.
I told David that Missoula had $184 million of total appropriations for fiscal year 2018 and didn't have a single set allocated specifically to veterans. I told the secretary that this seemed a little bit bizarre because Missoula County had the highest veteran suicide rate in the state of Montana, and the state of Montana had the highest veteran suicide rate in the entire country. And we don't even have a veterans coordinator. David agreed with me that municipalities really need to chip in to help out the federal government because, as you know, the VA is expanding and making a clinic here in Missoula, but that won't be enough, and they can use all the help they can get. We have the largest budget ever passed in the history of Missoula right now, and we spend money on all kinds of different things. And the fact that we don't have anything allocated to veterans leads me to believe that you guys think that all the things that we're spending money on right now is more important to you than helping the men and women that have served our country and fought for our freedoms.
All right, and that was Jesse Ramos talking about that. Moving on, we got a proclamation from Marilyn Mahler. She reads a proclamation. Of course, it's for the University of Montana and those who are leaving and those who are retiring. There's a lot of things happening at the University of Montana. Many of people at the University of Montana are being asked to retire early or being bought out of their contracts or tenure just so the University of Montana can save money since they don't have the enrollment to support a lot of the teachers that are there as well. So here's a proclamation read by Marilyn Mahler.
Whereas the University of Montana, located in Missoula, has been the seat of learning for thousands of men and women, and whereas these former students have moved on and honored this institution by being successful in their endeavors and their contributions to society, and whereas this was made possible through the care, guidance, and mentoring received from university faculty, staff, and administrators, and whereas retired faculty, staff, and administrators gather today to celebrate their university careers, now, therefore, we, Mayor of the City of Missoula and the Missoula Board of County Commissioners, hereby jointly proclaim August 23rd, 2017 as UM Retirees Day and invite all citizens to join in recognizing the University of Montana retirees and the contributions made by these individuals to the lives of all students and the well-being of society.
All right, so that was the proclamation that was read, and today is University of Montana Retiree Day. So homeward, let's move on to the next topic almost right away. It was a successful bidder on the Creekside Apartments. It's over 161 units. One of the units is a manager unit, blah, 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 located just off of East Broadway before East Missoula. Homeward has created an entity that will own and control called Creek Street Apartments, LLC, that will own and operate Creekside Apartments. Homeward's ownership of these units will ensure continued access to affordable housing units in Missoula. Andrea Davis, executive director of Homeward, talks about renters and about when she basically said the statistics of renters versus homeowners in Missoula, it was crazy. So without further ado, here is she.
52% of Missoulians are renters, and that's significant. Over half of our community are renters. And like I mentioned earlier, 47% of Missoulians spend over 30% of their income on housing. Half of those spend over 50%. And another interesting fact here is that in the 2017 Missoula Organization of Realtors report, there is a large disparity between the area median income of Missoula's homeowners, 63,000, and renters, which is about 28,000. So this is just basically proving the point that affordable rentals are necessary for our workforce.
All right, so once again, that was the executive director, Andrea Davis. For those of you who've lived in Missoula for a long time, you have noticed that within the last, let's say, 20, 30 years or so here in Missoula, housing prices has quadrupled, like rent, even housing, all those payments have quadrupled, while only your wages, the basic wages in Missoula have only doubled. So, and I basically based that off of some of the older generations, and I asked them, is like, wow, so basically, I mean, from what they've told me, it's like they, back in the 80s, most people would pay $200-$300 per month for their rent, and they would basically make half of what they make today. So that's a very interesting take on that as well. So anyways, here is Jenna Staten, whose church helps 40-plus families with housing, and is really happy to hear about this plan about Homeward taking this as well.
So we are very committed to studying housing and supporting the City of Missoula and the City Council in certainly keeping Creekside as a affordable housing for the future, perpetuity if possible, and we would like to see more efforts like this so that we increase the housing supply because we know how tight it is.
All right, so she's with Missoula's First United Methodist Church, and what her and her organization, you know, the people that were standing up behind her. So as you can see, those people represent the organization up and behind her. She was talking about how her organization helps families who are in crisis, who basically families who are homeless. So she says she helps over 40 families, and since they all are also going through their own renovations of their own, finding places for these folks and families are even more difficult as well. So the city did move forward to acquire Creekside Apartments at $10,312,500 multifamily revenue bond. So it's money that's already there. So they're not taking it out of the general fund, just so you guys know. And that's kind of what's happening with that. There's more to this meeting. They bought some open agriculture land, 168 acres, to the Missoula Open Space Bond from the 2015 Open Space Bond. So a lot of this that they were talking about during the meeting, I didn't necessarily harp on too much of this because there was a lot of people saying that, like, this is good for the community. It helps. Oh, sorry about that. That was not cool. But it helps promote farming and agriculture and grazing of cattle for this new agricultural land that they bought. But if you want to watch the meeting in its entirety, it's not too long. A lot of these meetings have been short. They just got finished doing the fiscal year budget, so most of that's been taken care of. So a lot of the meetings have been shorter. So for any information about the city of Missoula website and how to, I'll teach you guys where you basically can go to find out more information about what the city is doing, what the city is going to do in terms of agendas, webcasts, and minutes by logging on to ci.missoula.mt.us. It's as easy as Googling City of Missoula, and it's the first thing that shows up. But if it says ad next to it, just ignore it, just skip it. Usually, sometimes they always have like an ad or two above basically every search engine because, you know, search engines have to make some kind of money. But you go to your government. You go to Agendas, Webcast, Minutes. You click on that. And you wait a little bit, and this thing pops up. So it's a wonderful. And the agenda, you get to see basically, if you see MP4 next to these, that means the meetings have already taken place, and you guys can watch the meeting as its entirety. You can go to Agenda to see any upcoming items that really affect you or affect somebody that you know or something that you want to get involved with. You can go to these meetings of the committee meetings because this is when they basically go through the details and try to get through all these little finite details and whatnot that go onto the consent agenda on Monday where they will be voted on. Sometimes some of the basic stuff, if it's mostly just like, I guess it's like appointing someone to a committee, it's usually just like, you know, we don't need to have a public hearing about somebody who can be on a committee, that kind of thing. So they usually try to bunch those up in a category so they're just like they vote on it as a package rather than vote on it individually. So it saves a lot of time, but also if there's any kind of big issue that they do talk about, that's when they host a public hearing on your the city council meetings as well every Monday from 7 till midnight. They said that they'd have to cut it off by midnight at the latest because they had an ordinance passed and everything. So it's from 7 to at the latest midnight. Yeah, so that's basically all you need to know with the City of Missoula's website. If you want to learn more information about the City of Missoula, go to ci.missoula.mt.us. If you want to find out more information about MCAT, you go to mcat.org. MCAT.org is also your reference to everything that is on our channel. And also, we do all the city council meetings. So if you're interested in actually accessing any of those meetings as well, you could go to 190. You just click on this link right here. 190 is our civic channel. And it brings you to this website. And it basically gives you all the stuff from the city council meetings and more, but also Western Montana Fair. I did a nice little highlight video for everybody so you guys can see this. Me and Johanna Siempa, she and I, we did the Western Montana Fair. We get some highlights. We did a bunch of things, but for every thing we missed, basically, oh, sorry, here is the website. Whew! You're on my face most of the time. I'm on manual right now, so this is the area where you guys can go. You can click on channel 190 on our hyperlink at mcat.org. And you go, and it brings you to this page, and it gives you a whole list of the things, starting from the most recently uploaded to our video on demand, to the last updated. But we have plenty of content up there for any of you who want to have quick access to all the city council, county, all the government meetings that we went through. And yeah, I mean, of course, if you want to access my show and all the other things that happen on MCAT, including City Band and all the MEGs and all the new programs that are going to be airing on MCAT's channel 189, you click on channel 189, which brings you to this. Nice little website. See, the most recent thing that was uploaded was the Missoula City Band Concert Series. It tells you the length of the program, the date it was filmed, and it basically has a brief description about what it's all about. And Wake Up Missoula will be updated for today, so it will be the most recent updated on video on demand this afternoon as well. So if you want more information about my morning show, you can go to wakeupmissoula.wixsite.com/wakeupmissoula. So nice, we made you write out twice. You can go to click on videos, and you can see the last episode. And more, you can see our summer series from our kids, featuring the kids from our summer camps, our Boys and Girls Club. You can see Dubbin Stuff, and you can see all the interviews that I have had from our many different organizations that come through here, and also some people who are visiting up and through town. And of course, I just need to highlight my stop motion anthology that you guys can totally check out. It's over an hour long. I'm very proud of it. It took a lot of work. It was over 27 weeks of short 3-minute episodes all compiled into one amazing video. So you guys can check that out anytime. But it is Wednesday, and it is time for Dubbin Stuff. So I like this movie so much, I made a second one of Dubbin Stuff, and it's called Rage at Dawn.
Smell. Beans don't make you angry. Angry makes you angry.
Maybe if we had more than beans here.
What? Maybe if you guys got off your lazy butts and actually worked for a living, we'd have more than just beans. I've gotten used to the smell.
If you're any kind of woman, you know exactly how to cook beans.
How dare you? What do you think this is? All you guys ever do is sit around, eat beans, and poop everywhere. Poop, poop, poop. If we had some real money coming around here, we'd be able to get meat or whatever.
There you go again, just like yelling at us, and like all this stuff just happened, all with the like yelling and the thing.
A man is only as good as his woman is nice. Must explain why you're single. But what would I know, right?
Do you honestly think that you could just talk to my wife like that?
Well, you know, the longer you're single, you're just like, you know what? Well, go ahead and say it. I don't care. Who gives a crap? Well, long story short, that's why I can't have any kids. Now, where do we can get more of these beans and what? No! Oh, did you just walk in? I didn't even notice you. You're late for beans. They're delicious.
You don't know me. That's disgusting. You guys been doing all day eating beans? Huh!
We saved some beans for you too, son.
I don't want any beans!
Nah, don't get messing with my bean time. I know how to tell you this, but I respect you now.
Alright, you guys relax right
don't
now.
Don't tell me to relax. It makes me feel less relaxed. And you, fart person, I don't need your respect. I can earn it myself. You hear me? The only respect I need is self-respect. Now you better put that kitchen knife down before you regret it. I don't think I'm gonna regret it. Maybe not now. Maybe not tomorrow. But you will. You will regret holding that knife against me. I'm gonna show you who's boss. Or my name isn't Meriwether Lewis. Oh, hey, how's it going over there?
I don't wanna talk about it.
Why the heck not? Why can't you be more open about your feelings?
Because I just don't want to talk about it, okay?
Well, that's not a good enough answer for me.
I don't care if it's not a good enough answer for you.
Was it because I forgot your birthday? Because, you know, I'm really sorry. I didn't mean to do that.
It's for the last time. It's not about
my
birthday.
Well, then what the heck is it all about? I go out there, I make a good living, and I put, you know, food on the table. This has gone on long enough.
All right, let's talk about some events that are happening in and around Missoula. Let's kick it off with Pole Fitness. Mask Studio is doing a pole fitness and dance as an innovative way, blah, 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 blood pumping and pole dancing, all sorts of wonderful things. And that happens Monday at 7 p.m. and Wednesdays at 9 a.m. It starts this morning, and you can check it out. It's at the Mask Theater. Basically, all levels are appreciated, and it does all sorts of things. And Mask is a nonprofit. So Create the Rainbow Cooking Camp is at Taste Buds Kitchen. It is a class that teaches people how to cook, and the only thing you pay for is for the basic lesson and the ingredients as well. So you basically get to learn how to cook, and it's a great for kids ages 4 to 8 years old. Then it starts this morning. There's Merry Place and Blue Moon at Karis Park. It's going to be music by Merry Place and Blue Moon. There's children activities hosted by Animal Wonders, which is a nonprofit here in Missoula that actually gets exotic animals that are threatened and cannot basically be released back into the wild. So they're not just taking animals from the wild. So it's rescuing animals that would have otherwise been either put down or just basically on display, and they're using them for educational purposes and to get money so they can support and basically feed these animals. And this is happening from 11 a.m. to 2 p.m. at Karis Park. Get to learn about Nano is through the Explore Science through engaging exhibits at Spectrum Discovery Center. And this is for $3.50 for anyone 4 and over. And if you're under 3, you get in free. Kids Table at the Library. This is a wonderful meal opportunity provided by the Missoula Food Bank and USDA. And is a way for kids 18 and under. So you can be 18 and get a free meal at the Missoula Public Library. And for every meal served, it's more grant money that can be given to the Missoula Food Bank as well. So basically, having a free meal gives more people opportunity to get a job at the Missoula Food Bank. Just think about it that way. So, you know, there's no such thing as a free meal, but in this case, you give some. There's such a thing as a free meal that leads to more jobs. Afternoon matinee movies at the Missoula Public Library. Also, at the public library was the kids table. You can see films every second and fourth Wednesday of the month. It's a free afternoon movie, and they usually do this in the large meeting room. If you want to know what movie it is, call 721-BOOK or 721-2665 for the title of the film. It starts at 2 p.m. this afternoon. Middle School Writers Group is at 3:30 p.m. at the Missoula Public Library. So there's a lot of Missoula Public Library events happening, and Middle School Writers Group is for a good way for kids who are struggling with reading and writing to help catch up in time for when they go into high school, because once they hit high school, it gets a lot harder for a lot of the kids who are in middle school who are struggling with basically writing and their writing skills. So it's a great opportunity. It happens from 3:30 to 5 p.m., and there's also chocolate to entice some of the kids to come on down. Bob Ross Night, this happened at the Zootown Arts Community Center. So get your best Bob Ross wig, and you get a paint with videos of Bob Ross. MCAT has been basically broadcasting old Bob Ross videos since Bob Ross from public broadcasting systems has become public domain. So MCAT has been broadcasting Bob Ross. So, and you can access it online pretty much anywhere. There's a lot of great things with Bob Ross, and he, from what I hear, he basically had like he basically would paint constantly to keep up with his program. So he'd basically paint the painting like 5 times before he'd actually do it on camera. So I thought that was pretty interesting when I learned about that. But here are some of your late night events that are happening. You got Sharon in the Groove celebrating the music of Fish with a PH, and that starts at 4:30 during the happy hour at Top Out Lounge. Imagine Jam Society. It's a public jam at Imagination Brewing Company starting at 6 p.m. Going down, play some music with some people, and hang out. Joe Pug is going to be playing folk music at 7 p.m. at the Top Hat. And here are all the karaoke's happening at Eagles Lodge tonight, Badlander, and Sunrise Saloon. And without further ado, here is an art clip. And this is an art clip that will basically end after this week. So I'm going to show it today and on Friday. And that's it. This is the end of this art clip being featured at the Missoula Art Museum. So when I come back, I'll talk about your Thursday events after this.
Thank you.
Hey guys, welcome back. Here are some of your Thursday events in Missoula. Tiny Tales at the Missoula Public Library starts at 10:30 a.m. It's a way to engage the youth and kids who are birthed to 3 years of age to basically learn how to learn new words. Basically, kids that age learn 9 new words every day, and it's a great way for kids to learn through reading. Little Bugs Early Child Education is at the Missoula Insectarium starting at 11 a.m. tomorrow morning. Little Bugs is a full hour of early childhood education in the Insectarium's classroom for children 5 or younger and their parents. Enjoy exciting programming and exploration tailored just for our young visitors and their parents. Each week, there'll be a new theme with exciting bug ambassadors to hold in touch, a short story time, games and crafts, free with the cost of admission, $4 for anyone over the age of 3, and you can join them as they play and learn about bugs. Howl's Moving Castle is going to be at the Roxy. It's on their ongoing series of, I think, Miyazaki films, and that's at 11 a.m. at the Roxy Theater. Yeah, and it's basically Howl's Moving Castle is about a wizard who lost his heart, and through the power of love, through this one girl who is also cursed herself, must rescue him for his own sake and also for her own sake by doing so. Anyways, a meditation for veterans is happening at 1 p.m. at the Learning Center at Red Willow. This is a short 1 to 1:45 for if you're a veteran. They help with many things, including breathing exercises, and if for some veterans who have some PTSD as well, they have a lot of things there as well. Learning Center at Red Willow is a great resource for people who are veterans and people who are not veterans and who want to help as well. Lego Club is happening at the Missoula Public Library. It's every Thursday from 3:30 to 5 p.m. and it's at the Dragon's Rug in the children's area or otherwise specified. And you can do this as children under 12 must be accompanied by an adult. So it's just fun with Legos. Monty Dolak auction opening reception at 5 p.m. at the Roxy. You can join them for a very special art opening with Monty Dolak at the Roxy Theater Lobby. The event will kick off a month-long silent auction of a very special collection signed by Dolak himself through a Dolak film and theater posters made possible by Very Generations by Mike and Joe Knapcat in support of the Roxy's historic restoration. So if you haven't already noticed that their front of their building has changed and the colors and all that stuff, they want to be able to take tickets at the front window. They want to adjust it a little bit for that as well. It's going to be pretty cool what they're doing with it right now, and I like the way it looks right now for sure. Adventure Paws. So sometimes with this smoke, kids and animals are affected by some of the air quality and stuff like that, but the Wagon Indoor Dog Park is a great way for your dogs to run around in a safe, clean indoor environment, and this starts at 6 p.m. It's Adventure Paws. You can join them for play dates and help your dogs basically get acclimated to other dogs. For members, it's a free event. For non-members, it's $10 for the entire families. Humans are free. But of course, it's your first time at Wagon. Please register your pups at the website at www.wagon.org, and it's spelled WAGGN.org. So Symphonic Cirque, Mask Studio is doing a kind of like a Cirque Soleil. I don't know why I said Olay. I don't know. Circus Delay. I'm not. But anyways, it's at Mask Theater. They do silk. I would say silk screening, but it's silk dancing. It's where they basically suspend themselves in silk. You know what I'm talking about. I hope you do, because I've been corrected so many times, and I just cannot remember for the life of me what to call it. but it's going to be aerial silk. I think that's what it's called. And there are going to be all sorts of dancing and all sorts of contemporary dance type stuff. And that starts at 7 p.m. It's $35 for all ages. And if you want more information, go to MissoulaEvents.net. John Floridis is playing at Jaffer's Brewing Company tonight at 6 p.m. You got live jazz at Plonk. You got combat entertainment at Sunrise Saloon. I don't know what that is. I looked it up. It just basically said it's combat entertainment. What else do you need? That's not what it says. The last line I just added. Karaoke at VFW. And you got Jeff Crosby and the Refugees. Rock music at the Top Hat Lounge tomorrow night on Thursday. But also, Thursday is downtown tonight. They're going to have it's a community event at the it's basically out to lunch, but it's dinner in the park, which is happening Thursday night from 5:30 to 8:30 p.m. And hopefully by that time, Thursday, they said tonight and Thursday morning, it should rain. So hopefully a lot of the smoke will be cleared up by then, so you'll be able to enjoy some outdoor activity, if only for a day or two, because the particulate matter might be at its lowest again, because that's what happened when it rained on Sunday, is that we were basically green and good after it rained on the 13th in August. So we'll see how it works out. And if you want more information, you go to MissoulaEvents.net for any upcoming events and more. If you want to find out more information about my show, you go to wakeupmissoula.wixsite.com/wakeupmissoula. Thank you guys for joining me, and I hope to have a wonderful birthday. And I was glad to be here for my birthday on this morning of August the 23rd, and I'll see you guys on August the 25th, and I'll tell you about how my birthday day went, but I hope to do absolutely nothing for my birthday. And that's kind of the nice thing, when you're younger, there's an expectations to have a great birthday, but when you're older, it's just like, I just don't want to do anything on my birthday. Is that enough? That's kind of what I want to do. So here's to doing nothing on your birthday. Oh, I have a cup and everything. So thanks for joining me, and for Wake Up Missoula, I'm Scott Ranf.